Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Yeshi Chanzom. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Tuesday, the 11th of May. Three terrorists neutralized in encounter with security forces in India's Jammu and Kashmir. Pakistan's army chief reiterates support for Afghan peace process as violence surges. And Nepal's president initiates process to form new government, asks opposition parties to stake claim for new PM. And now for all the details. Security forces on Tuesday neutralized three terrorists in an encounter in Anantnag district of India's Jammu and Kashmir. An official said the slain terrorists belonged to Pakistan-based Lashkar-e-Taiba terror outfit.
Three terrorists were neutralized by security forces in an encounter in Anantnag district of India's Jammu and Kashmir on Tuesday. The encounter broke out after security forces had launched a cordon and search operation in Kokarnag area in Anantnag based on specific inputs. Inspector General of Jammu and Kashmir Police Vijay Kumar informed that the slain terrorists were identified as members of Pakistan-based Lashkar-e-Taiba or LET terror outfit. Search operations were still underway in the area till the last reports came in. This came a week after security forces gunned down three terrorists belonging to Al Badr terror outfit in Shopian district of India's Jammu and Kashmir. India has long accused Pakistan of arming and infiltrating terrorists from across the border to spread unrest in Kashmir Valley. Pakistan, however, denies the charges.
India's coronavirus crisis showed scant sign of easing on Tuesday, with a 7-day average of new cases at a record high and international health authorities warning the country's variant of the virus poses a global concern. The country's daily virus cases rose by 329,942, while deaths from the disease rose by 3,876, according to the Health Ministry data.
India's daily coronavirus cases on Tuesday rose by 329,942, while the deaths from the disease rose by 3,876, according to the Health Ministry data. This is for the second time after four straight days that the country's COVID-19 count has risen by less than 400,000 fresh infections. The number of new reported cases is also falling in the national capital, New Delhi, but the fight is far from over for the overwhelmed health system. As the lack of medical staff and dire shortages of oxygen and beds in India continue, the Gurdwara Rakabgarh Sahib, one of the places where Sikhs gather to worship, has been transformed into a 250-bed COVID-19 multi-purpose facility.
Delhi mein corona ke case ab kam ho rahe hain. कोरोना की दूसरी लहर भी अब कम हो रही है थोड़ी आप सभी के सहयोग से लॉकडाउन भी सफल रहा हमने पिछले कुछ दिनों में ऑक्सीजन के बेड भी खूब बढ़ाए हैं
इंडियन कोरोना वायरस इन्फेक्शंस एंड डेथ्स हैव इंक्रीज कॉल्स फॉर द गवर्नमेंट टू लॉक डाउन द वर्ल्ड सेकंड मोस्ट पॉपुलस कंट्री द वर्ल्ड हेल्थ ऑर्गेनाइजेशन ऑन मंडे सेड दैट द कोरोना वायरस वेरिएंट फर्स्ट आइडेंटिफाइड इन इंडिया लास्ट ईयर वाज बीइंग क्लासिफाइड as a variant of global concern, with some preliminary studies showing that it spreads more easily. The variant has already spread to other countries and many nations have moved to cut or restrict movements from India.
Moving on, the Pakistani Army Chief visited Afghanistan on Monday and offered Islamabad support for the Afghanistan peace process in a meeting with President Ashraf Ghani in Kabul amid growing violence as the United States withdraws its troops. Pakistan is a key player in moves to resolve the conflict between the Western-backed government and the Taliban insurgents. Pakistan's Army Chief General Qamar Javed Bajwa met Afghan President Ashraf Ghani on Monday, and both the leaders discussed bilateral relations and the peace process, among others. In this meeting, President Ghani said that the role of countries in the region, especially Pakistan, is critical for peace in Afghanistan due to its influence on the Taliban, according to the Presidential Palace statement. Bajwa also met with Abdullah Abdullah, chairman of the High Council for National Reconciliation. Neighboring Pakistan is regarded as a key player in the Afghan peace process. In the past, Islamabad has been accused of harboring the insurgent Taliban, but in recent years, Washington and other Western powers have acknowledged its efforts to push militant group to take part in peace talks. The Taliban announced on Sunday that they would commit to a three-day ceasefire for the Islamic religious holiday of Eid later this week. Violence has risen starkly in Afghanistan in recent weeks, with the Taliban launching attacks throughout the country and a huge unclaimed attack taking place on a school in Kabul on Saturday that killed dozens of students. Meanwhile, the United States welcomed the Taliban's announcement of ceasefire and urged it to extend the ceasefire as U.S. troops withdraw from Afghanistan, State Department spokesman Ned Price said on Monday.
We note the Taliban has denied involvement in the attack, and we welcome their announcement of a three-day ceasefire over the upcoming Eid holiday. We call on the Taliban and Afghan leaders to engage seriously in the ongoing peace process to ensure the Afghan people enjoy a future free of terrorism and of senseless violence.
U.S. condemned the Saturday school attack, but was still looking into who was responsible for the attack, Price said. The Taliban has denied involvement in the attack. More news from Afghanistan. Schoolgirls who survived a deadly car bomb attack in Afghanistan this past weekend have expressed they are determined to continue studies to show the insurgents that they cannot stop them from studying. The car bomb attack outside their school, followed by two more bombings, killed more than 65 people.
14-year-old Rukhaya Bakshi on Monday recalled being caught in a huge blast in the west of Kabul. A car bomb was detonated in front of the Sayyid al-Shuhada school this past Saturday, and two more bombs exploded when students rushed out in panic. Rukhaya, who was receiving treatments at a hospital, determined to continue her studies to show insurgents that they cannot stop them from studying. The attack, which President Ashraf Ghani blamed on Taliban insurgents, killed at least 68 people and wounded over
165.
Security has been intensified across capital Kabul after the attack, but authorities said they would not be able to provide security to all schools, mosques and other public places. Following the Saturday's attack, two more blasts happened late on Sunday and early on Monday, which killed at least 13 people and injured several. Violence has been rising sharply in recent weeks after the US announced it would withdraw all its troops by September.
During the Islamic holy month of Ramadan, fasting families living in Pakistan's Karachi city with no running water depend on the services of mashkis, who deliver water using goat hide bags. 60-year-old Muhammad Ramzan supplies water to communities during the Ramadan, but worries that the days of his profession are numbered. Muhammad Ramzan pumps water into a large goatskin bag before carrying it down an alley and up several flights of stairs to deliver to a resident in Karachi, Pakistan's largest city. For more than four decades, Ramzan has been a mashki or water bearer, an age-old profession now in decline as water companies and tankers increasingly supply residents. But his services are at least in high demand during the Islamic holy month of Ramadan, during which fasting can be a challenge when the weather is hot.
ये काम तो मुश्किल है, मगर क्या करें, हम अपनी मजदूरी करते हैं। ये रमजान का महीना है, लोगों से पानी नहीं भरा जाता, हम आप पानी इनको दे के जाते हैं। वाले हमें अल्लाह पाक सवाब देगा और इसी अल्लाह पाक हमारी मुश्किल आसान करेगा। और हमारी मजदूरी भी बन जाती है।
और रमजान के महीने में ये बेचारे माशिया इतनी मेहनत करते हैं, इनकी मेहरबानी है माशियों की जो यहाँ आते हैं हमारे बिल्डिंगों में, पांच पांच माले चार चार माले चढ़ते हैं, हमें पानी दे जाते हैं। मैं दोबारा माशियों की मेहरबानी है कि ये हमें पानी दे जाते हैं कि पानी टैंकर वाले ये लोग तो जवाब ही नहीं देते, तो पैसे भी बहुत लेते हैं।
Water bearers have existed in South Asia for centuries, providing water to travelers and warriors during battles in ancient times. But Ramzan worries that the days of the mashki are numbered. Karachi needs about 1200 million gallons per day of water to meet the demand of its estimated population of 20 million people. But officials say its two main water sources only provide the city with about 580 million gallons per day. Some of the water is lost due to dilapidated infrastructure and water theft, while experts say climate change and dams also reduce water supplies.
In news from Nepal, major opposition parties of the Nepali parliament have started preparations to form a new government after Prime Minister K.P. Sharma Oli lost the vote of confidence at lower house on Monday. This comes as Nepali President Bidya Devi Bhandari called on all parties to stake claim to form majority government.
Major opposition parties of Nepali Parliament have started preparations to form new government after Prime Minister K.P. Sharma Oli lost vote of confidence at lower house on Monday. Nepal's new government, which would be coalition of more than two parties representing in the parliament, already have started consultations over the next leadership. This comes as later on Monday, Nepali President Bidya Devi Bhandari called on all parties to stake claim to form majority government after Oli's failed vote of confidence in the parliament.
Matdan ma upasthit hununcha, bahumatle pradhan mantri ko chahi prastav lai aswikrit gareko cha. Tyas karanle K.P. Sharma Oli bata chahi ni yo pratinidhi sabha अब वहाँ प्रधानमन्त्री नरहनुहोस् नहुनुहोस् भन्ने नै चाहिँ नि प्रतिनिधि सभाको चाहिँ नि चाहना हो। त्यस कारणले अर्को वैकल्पिक सरकार बनाउन लागि हामी दलहरूले प्रयत्न गर्छौँ र अवश्य पनि अब हाम्रो प्रयत्न अनुसार चाहिँ नि नयाँ प्रधानमन्त्री नियुक्त हुनेछ बन्नुहुनेछ भन्ने हामीलाई विश्वास छ।
Prime Minister K.P. Sharma Oli lost a vote of confidence in Parliament as he could only garner 93 votes, way less than 136 that he needed to prove the House's majority. As many as 124 votes were cast against him and 15 lawmakers stated neutral.
62-year-old woodcutter Sukha Bahadur Tamang is busy working round the clock to ensure continued supply of wood as its demand has increased for cremations in Nepal amid the new wave of coronavirus. The Himalayan nation recorded the highest single-day COVID-19 death tally of 139 on Monday.
As the number of COVID-19-related fatalities are increasing in Nepal, so has the demand of wood required to cremate the dead. 62-year-old woodcutter Sukha Bahadur Tamang, associated with government-run Timber Corporation of Nepal for the past 30 years, is busy working round the clock to ensure continued supply of wood to the Pashupati Crematorium in capital Kathmandu. No matter what and how the weather and conditions are, Tamang along with six other fellow workers have been making sure that funeral pyres never face shortage or have to wait for wood logs.
जिल्लाभरिको त अब सबभन्दा ठुलो मेन अब घाट त यो पशुपति आरी घाट हो अनि यो बन्द सन्द यहाँ बन्दको टाइममा त अब यसमा के चाहिँ आर्मी सर्मी राखेर भए पनि स्कडिङ गरेर चाहिँ हामीले यहाँ चाहिँ चलिरहेछ।
अपार्ट फ्रम दि वुड कटर्स दि वर्कर्स एट दि क्रेमेटोरियम अल्सो हेभ बिन वर्किङ राउन्ड दि क्लक एट दिस डिफिकल्ट टाइम विच इज लाइकली टु इलोङ्गेट टिल जुन when cases are likely to peak. Nepal has reported a total of 403,794 coronavirus cases and 3,859 deaths so far.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now, our viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com
You can also visit us on facebook.com/AsiaNewsline and follow us on Twitter at AsiaNewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.